What happens in Vegas comes to you from Vegas. It doesn't stay there. Let's go back to the Consumer Electronics Show. A surprise special guest with Julia. Julia?
That's right, Tyler. I'm joined now by Jeff Bewkes, the CEO of Time Warner. Jeff, thanks so much for talking to us. Jeff, the hot topic here this year at CES is tablets. These are great devices for watching content on. How will tablets affect your bottom line?
They're great. Better, more screens, better definition. You can watch TV now on your tablet. You can watch your favorite network. You can read your favorite magazine.
And that means more revenue?
Absolutely, because if you have more viewership, more engagement, you get more revenue, more advertising, more subscriptions.
You were just on the stage moments ago with Ivan Seidenberg, Verizon CEO, talking about TV everywhere. Will this keep consumers from cutting the cord?
Sure, you know, consumers are, well, the reason we were talking about television is that this is the second golden age of television. There are more people watching television than ever before. They're watching it for longer hours. The ratings are up. The subscriptions are up. The advertising is up. TV is a bursting industry, and it's going to be not only on your TV, it's going to be on every screen you have, and it's going to be on demand. And, key point, you don't have to pay extra. You've already paid.
And that's the thing that's going to keep consumers.
That's why it's so important, because the TV that everybody loves, remember, all these indications are up, and the TV is getting better. Now you're going to be able to watch it whenever you want, on whatever screen you want, and it doesn't cost you any more to do it.
Tyler, you want to jump in here?
I want to jump in and talk, Mr. Bewkes, a little more broadly about the business and your strategy. Your company had been, at one time, a kind of vertically integrated content and distribution company. It is really now purely a content company. You got rid of Time Warner Cable. I'm thinking of another company that is very close to our hearts here, and that is Comcast. It's gone another way. It's decided that it wants to be in content and delivery. Why did it not work for you, and why do you think they've made a different choice?
Well, it did work for us fine. If you look at the value of Time Warner content and Time Warner Cable separate, it's the best stock gain in media over the last couple of years. So that all worked fine. The reason that Comcast wants to get in the content business is because it's a good business. So I think they're trying to get from the 100% investment in just cable distribution and get more of their future and their investment return out of content, because content is such a good business.
In the distribution business, Netflix is the new 800-pound gorilla, and you have spoken in great detail in opposition to Netflix.
No, not opposition. I would say it's like a 200-pound chimp. It's not an 800-pound gorilla.
But does Netflix pose a threat to your premium cable business?
You mean like subscription
like HBO?
Well, it's a competitor. But as I think back about HBO and how great HBO is doing right now, because viewership, programming, subscribers, profits, everything is great at HBO. HBO's had a lot of competition over the years, and HBO's done just fine. And what you're about to see, every HBO subscriber, if you're out there and you have HBO and you subscribe to it, you're gonna have it on demand, on every device, every tablet, every handheld that you have, for no extra money. So it's going to get better and better, and the programming budgets and the things coming are better, and they're much better, fresher, much bigger audience than anything on another service,
but,
whether it's Netflix or anything.
Will Netflix be a threat?
No, it's just another competitor. You know, we have plenty of competition. That's fine.
And the ad business, how's it going?
Well, remember, HBO has no ads, so now it's the ad business on TNT, CNN, and so forth. Fantastic. So the advertising revenues in the cable network business generally and in our company are doing really healthy numbers. And Turner Network Group is, I think, at the top of the TV universe in terms of ad growth.
We'll be continuing to watch those ad numbers through 2011.
Yeah, but really the news, if you go back to your tablets, you're going to see your favorite networks and your favorite magazines on every device, including tablets. You don't have to pay extra. You don't have to use them differently. You can use the things, the networks, the way you're used to.
Well, we have to leave it there, Jeff Bewkes, CEO of Time Warner. Thanks so much for joining us. Guys, back over to you in the studio.
I wonder what tablet he owned.